Well, hi everyone. Here I am back at work. I know it's Friday afternoon and everybody's raring to get out of here, but I decided let's give that time capsule project one more try before the snow flies. Anyway, the sun's starting to get low. I probably have about an hour and a half to get what I want to do done tonight. Hey everybody, this sounds promising. $84.85, that sounds like a nice number. Yeah, let's see what it is. Oh, there we go. A nice little penny. Yay. Looks like a modern one's kind of crusty. Very good. Well, there we are. 1968 American penny. That was pretty neat find. Good old memorial. And Abe Lincoln on the back. Very nice. Well, here I am under this crazy fir tree, great big old tree. It must be almost 50 years old itself. Kind of wonder. Anyway, and I'm running into all that. Lots of roots, hey? Look at all that. Now down in here, right about there, is an iron bar. And it goes from here, I think it's ending right about here, and it goes underneath. There's a big, big root right here. It's almost growing right around the iron bar. There's no way I'm getting that out of the ground. But anyway, very interesting what I'm finding. I don't think it's an indicator of the time capsule, but could be like one of those other stakes that I found earlier. Well, this is great. Look at this. I just stood up from digging over there. I started walking over here, and I noticed something. This is why I like to come where all the intermediates hang out at school, the grade 7, 8s. They're very careless. Take a look. Dime. Nickel. Nickel. Dime. Dime. And nickel. How do you like that? Isn't that great? And that's just looking. Alright, listen to this squeaker. I don't know what that would be. Hopefully it's a nice large coin. Let's check it out together. Oh, what's that? Huh. Oh, I don't know. This kind of looks interesting. Huh. It's got an elastic on it. And looks like a Flintstone. Yabba dabba doo. Well, this one was deep, up to about there on my shovel. That's, I don't know, probably about 2 feet almost, maybe close to 18 inches. Yeah, anyway, take a look. Great big iron collar or piece of a water main or something. Anyway, it was a nice, interesting signal, but not too strong, but really deep. Well, here I am. And look at that, it's getting pretty out there. Sunlight behind the trees there, it's all pink. Sun's going down. And I know what you think. Maybe my, I think the same as my wife, that I'm a wingnut for being out here digging in the dirt. Hey, what do you think? Well, here I am, digging in the dark again. And I just found that. Looks like a lost bolt. And anyway, it's been a nice break. I think it's time to get back to life. Well, here's my wrap up for today. I had that funny coin spill right there. All that, those dimes and those nickels, they all came from one coin spill that was on the surface. And the two dug coins that I dug were from 1968, one American and one Canadian. I thought that was interesting. This is the third one of these that I've dug from that field. I could just imagine it's some kind of gate hinge or something like that. There's that big piece of cast iron there. And I found this here stone in one of the holes. It's all smooth and cut. Probably a broken piece of granite from a bathroom or something like that. And Barney rubble from the Flintstones. Anyway, it was good. Good little hunt for an hour. A little bit more than an hour that I went out. I thought, let's try and go for the time capsule, and another day without getting it was too bad. I'll have to keep at it though. Thanks for watching, and if you like to, could you subscribe below?